As many of you know, I live in Arizona, which means that I'm fortunate enough to get access to some really interesting golf minds, not just teachers, but also some people that have played for some really big schools. And I was recently playing with a kid, I guess he's a young man at this point, that was a former Arizona Sun Devil player. And I also was playing with someone that worked on the administrative side of the golf team at Southern University of California, which, as many of you know, Arizona and Southern California produces some really, really good golfers. And I was talking about their practice routines and kind of what they did in the day of the life as a college golfer. So I'm going to share with you some of the best tips and practice things that NCAA college golfers are currently using. Oh, yes, it's a video about practice.
Listen, we're talking about practice.
Let's do it right meow. All right, so let's jump into the kind of information they talked to me about. And I've also put together an Excel file that I'm gonna share with y'all. So if you want to, I'll put that in the link in the description below. That way you can kind of see what some of those drills are. And if you wanna practice them along at home, you can too as well. They have structured practice days, but each individual golfer is given structured practice based off of his or her specific disciplines they need to work on. And they spent their areas doing a lot of practice in these like four main areas. The biggest one was putting, right? They did a lot of putting, speed control, distance control, putts inside of 8 feet, putts inside of 5 feet, that goes without saying. The second thing they did was scrambling, but we'll get into that specifically because there's a unique thing they had to mention about scrambling that I never thought about. The third thing they practice on was their approach play average distances, right? They were working on approach play from like 90 to 145, 150 yards. That was a big crucial number, and we'll get to that in the video as well. Then the second thing they were working on was long irons, right? That 150 to 200 yard range. They spent a lot of time on those specific distances, but it's important to understand that just because the goal is to have what the test says, doesn't mean you always have to do it. Like, track your stats. Your goal is to improve, not to just come in and just beat the test. So the first one with the putting is they'd start with, you know, 10 putts from 3 to 4 feet, right? And it's normally 10 in a row, but it's really just to warm it up and try to get them really comfortable making 10 to 3 and 4 footers, but they wouldn't always make them, but they write it down, right? So the goal is to be 100% from 3 to 4 feet. Realistically, you're probably gonna be, you know, high 90s from 3 to 4 feet. So they start their putting practice, and that was one of the drills. The next putting drill was trying to make 8 out of 10 putts from 5 feet. So they wanted to be 80% of putts from 5 feet, which is tour average. And everybody gets this. You can go in a circle around the hole and, you know, pick a different hole each time or pick a different angle, however it is you want to do it. The other putting drill was 5 out of 10 from 8 feet. That's tour average, 50% from 8 feet. And again, they hit 10 putts from 8 feet, going to different holes or picking a different angle on the same hole. The next drill is called par 18 putting. And essentially what you're doing is on the practice putting green, you are basically playing 9 holes of putting golf, and you are selecting random distances between 25 and 45 feet. You're basically picking 3 easy distances. Let's just say somewhere between 20 to 25 feet, 3 medium distances, somewhere between 30 to 35. And then, you know, 3 really hard distances, which are gonna be like 40 feet plus. And your goal is to not 3-putt. And at the end of this, you're obviously tallying up your score, but you wanna know how many times you 3-putted. If you got a perfect 18, great. If you 3-putted once, maybe twice. So this is a really good way to gauge your ability and your skills to test your 3-putting. This is something that I'm gonna be doing a lot of because I definitely need a lot of work in this area. The next one is the 100 feet putting drill. This is something that's been covered by a lot of putting coaches, and it's done by a lot of tour pros. A lot of NCAA golfers use this. So you have 5 different sets of 4 putts. You start off with a 5-foot putt, a 10-foot putt, and then you go to a 15-foot putt and a 20-foot putt, and then you change each hole 5 times. The goal is to accumulate 100 feet of putting. And then the last putting drill, which is something that a lot of college golfers have instituted, which is the decade distance drill. I don't know if Scott Fawcett actually made it, but it's just the one that I most recently know of. It basically goes with you're setting tee pegs out between, you know, each with the feet apart. So you set one tee peg, I'll put visuals on the screen. You set up one tee peg or a coin or whatever you want to call it, a fake hole marker. And then you set another one a foot behind it, another foot behind that. basically what your goal is to start at, you know, 20 feet, and then you want to roll the putt inside of the first 2 feet of pegs. Then you move the ball back 6 inches or a foot, and you roll it again, and you try to roll it within the first 2 feet of those pegs. You go all the way back up to 40 feet. So for the first 20 feet, you try to roll it inside of 2 feet. For the next 30 feet, you try to roll it inside of 3 feet of pegs. And then from 40 feet, you try to roll it inside of 4 feet. Basically, the goal is you're trying to always hit to 10% of the total number. This is a good putting drill that just really focuses on getting distance control down. The next one is a chipping drill. It's 8 out of 10 inside of a 3-foot circle from 10 yards around any given flag on a practice screen. And obviously, your goal is to try to get those chips inside of a 10-foot or a 3-foot circle from around 10 yards, which is roughly 30 feet. The next one is 8 out of 10, but instead of trying to get it in a 3-foot circle, you get it in a 6-foot circle from 20 yards. So again, the drill is getting larger and giving you a bigger area to land because this is PGA Tour average. And then the next chipping drill is 8 out of 10 feet within an 8-foot circle, which is about a flag stick from 30 yards away. But their biggest focus and emphasis is when they're missing that green by 10 yards, 20 yards, whatever the case may be, they can confidently get up and close to the flag from pretty much anywhere around the course. You can obviously vary the difficulty of the chips that you want to hit based off of your skill level, but again, the goal is to try to get 80% of those chips inside of a target area based on how far you are away from the hole. And then another really good drill that they said they spent a lot of time doing, a lot of people have called it the gauntlet, some people call it the gladiator challenge. I know it as par 18. You basically are trying to get up and down for 9 consecutive holes around a practice screen. You choose 3 easy chips, you know, somewhere that's like relatively right off side of the green. Then you choose 3 medium ones. Maybe those are a little bit longer. Maybe you got to go over a bunker. And then you choose 3 that are extremely difficult. These are like really hard to get up and down, short-sighted. And your goal is to try to get up and down in 2 with every single one of these and get a perfect score of 18 over 9 holes. The next one, and this was in the Decade app, and it's one of the combines, and it's basically a 50 to 90 yard random pitch assessment, right? You get 10 to 15 random pitches between 50 and 90 yards, and your goal is to try to hit those numbers as consistently as possible. I'm not going to focus on this as much because it's not an area I need to improve on, but I will do it. It's probably really helpful if you have a launch monitor because you can really get the data down, but this one's a really hard one to do if you don't have a pitching area that is 50 to 90 yards long. Most people don't. Depending on how high or how low you are away from the number, you can either give yourself a pass or fail, or you can just add up how far or how short you were of hitting those numbers. And at the end of that practice, that'll be your score. These are all from Decade, and I found this pretty interesting because these combine tests, it's exactly what I heard from 2 other college golfers of these are the distances that they're practicing. So the first one is the 90 to 140 line test. Measure how far off line you're hitting your ball when a random number is given to you between 90 and 140 yards. Now, you can make this test more difficult by using a launch monitor and saying that you have to hit it to the number and you've got to hit it inside of a certain window. So you're basically selecting 2 targets out on the range and judging how far off line you are between hitting those shots, whether you're 5 yards off line, 10 yards off line, hopefully not 15 yards off line. And then at the end of this, you throw out your 2 worst ones and then basically add up your average score. And that's how you score this one. The next one is 140 to 190 yards line test. It's the exact same thing. You're picking a target out on the range. And basically you want to know if you were 5 yards off line, 10 yards off line, or 15 yards off line. And you're having random numbers generated between 140 and 190 yards. The next approach play is the 90 to 135 random, where again, you're given a random number, and it's not so much about direction as it is distance control. You're trying to measure how close you are hitting to that number that's given to you randomly between those between that range, and these are numbers that come up frequently, obviously when you're out on the golf course. And then the final one is the 135 to 185 random test. Again, trying to measure how close you are to hitting that number when given a random yardage between 135 and 185 yards. This would be considered, you know, shortage to long range game. And again, you're going to need either a launch monitor or some sort of device that's going to help you measure these distances. I would recommend getting a little cheapo PRGR Black launch monitor. It's something that's really effective for this type of practice, and it's really going to help you dial in those distances that are super important. And most of you, if you've done your data, I'd say probably 40 to 50% of your approach shots are gonna be inside of 135 to 185. The last one is a driver line test. And again, what they're trying to do is hit six drivers out of 10. So 60% of your drivers need to be inside of a 50-yard window. You can make the window bigger or smaller depending on how good or how poor you are at driving. But essentially, you're picking two different targets on the driving range and trying to make sure you can hit 60% of 10 drives, six out of 10 drives inside of that window. This is one I'm definitely gonna work on. And then the last one I'm gonna add into mine is the four quadrants. So I struggle with driver strike, so I'm going to frequently practice, you know, putting foot spray on my driver and trying to hit all four quadrants of the driver, high toe, high heel, low toe, low heel, just so I can practice moving my strike around the driver face. And this isn't gonna be like a pass or fail, it's just gonna be a like, do it until I succeed type of test, giving myself more familiarity with variability and hitting the driver on different parts of the face, and then obviously seeing if that will help me to control strike out the middle of the face. Just to summarize, it comes down to four areas that these college golfers are telling me they focus a lot on. Putting, like you can never do enough distance control when it comes to putting. Scrambling, so important. You are going to miss, I mean, I average 50% of my greens, so that means I'm missing 9 greens around. You have to be able to scramble effectively from anywhere on the course. There's no reason you can't scramble well. Like, those are the two biggest things that have to be practiced on. You got to measure yourself on those. The third was obviously approach shots, but really more importantly, longer approach shots, 150 to 230 yards. That's where you're really going to see a lot of gain in your ability to approach greens. And then obviously distance control inside of 150 yards being your scoring area. And then the fourth part is driving, right? Got to really be efficient off of the tee, making sure you control your ball inside of a certain distance. Deuces, people. Let's keep it moving.